Chicken, and I am pulling up my Facebook page because I got some words for us. Tonight we're telling the story about the turbulent capybara. Deep in the Amazon rainforest, there was a capybara. So turbulent, because this capybara would speak all the time and none of the other animals in the rainforest could hear this capybara. It would just speak and speak and speak and nobody would listen. Everybody would talk over this capybara and it would just get so frustrated, so turbulent.
That it would cause, like, I don't even know if I can call it a hurricane or what. I mean, it would cause like a storm, a tornado in the rainforest, and it would displace all their homes. All the animals' homes would be displaced.
The Amazonian creatures really, really resented becoming refugees. They had to spread out. They ended up going to the nearby towns. The capybara, however, really relished the silence. It was finally a moment for him to just take a breath, you know?
And you know, those other refugees, they all got adopted, certainly. There were many rescue organizations that popped up over time, you know, sent them overseas into new families and, you know, fancy houses, and the capybara suddenly started feeling resentment again. It was as if he had pushed them away and they just went to something better.
And then the capybara decided to become a foreign exchange student and moved to Canada, which was not known for any kind of hurricane activity, at least as far inland as he would be, which was Toronto.
But the capybara only spoke French. It was a very dignified capybara. And it got mixed up with cities. It wasn't in the Francophone country of Quebec. It was in Toronto. So it would just go, bonjour, bonjour. And everybody would just pass it by once again. People were just passing it by on the street.
And then, you know what happened? Our friend, the capybara, got really, really, really upset again. And he just couldn't contain it. And then he started all the turbulence and he ruined the city of Toronto and created a lot more refugees.
And the moral of this story is that you will always become what you most fear.
The turbulent capybara.
All right, co-pilot James, we've got, is it 5,000 feet left to go down?
Yeah, 4,850 or so, but if you want to be generic, I suppose.
Yeah. Yeah. Hey, is my ex-husband still on this plane back there?
Yep, he didn't move. Real
great. Wide. Gonna hit all the clouds!
Oh, no, no! Crystal, is this really worth it?
Terrible.
Yeah! It was only 2 months! It was only 2 months after we started going to counseling, and he said, I just feel like I can't do it anymore! That's why I fucked her!
Okay, everybody, the captain just turned on the fastened seatbelt sign for everybody except the fucker in route in 13B. So I guess if you're the fucker in 13B, don't fasten your seatbelt and just wait around and find out, bitch. I'm so sorry. I'm just reading what the captain wrote for me.
Crystal, we are lightheaded for a lawsuit here. I get it. I know that you're frustrated, and it's totally.
Oh, there's realistic. Lightning over there!
No, 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 come!
What were you saying about lawsuits? Doesn't Delta have lawyers?
Traffic control, tower, traffic control, this is C9100. Are you there?
This is air traffic control.
Thank you, traffic control. We have, we've got a rogue pilot here who's causing turbulence intentionally as a way of revenge.
Yeah, well, we've received clearance for that, any domestic flight. So as long as this is a domestic flight, it's okay. Also, there's a flock of geese at your 11 o'clock, about 200 miles out.
Oh, my God. Wait, so thank you, control? Domestic?
Geese are his favorite animal. I'm going to fucking smash him.
No. God. Just because we're on a domestic flight doesn't mean we need domestic violence, okay?
Canadian geese, it's not domestic.
Okay, it looks like we're flying through some geese. Everybody, please take that window and just put that cover down, and I'm again apologize, this was directly written for me, for that fucker in 13B. Take a look at the geese. Those geese are my heart. Think about what you did and despair.
Is there anything I can do to help calm you down so you don't kill all of us?
Oh, I definitely won't kill all of you. I'm perfectly in control. But I do want... He was seated on exit row, right? We confirmed that?
Yeah. Yep. Mm-hmm. Oh, no.
Okay. I'm going to get us down to, like, 200 feet or something, like, kind of safe so that if he falls out and only breaks things, he doesn't die. He feels the pain.
No, are we gonna push him out of the window? No! Oh my God! Attendant, no, don't listen to her!
This is air traffic control. I just want to clarify that you are headed towards Canadian border soon.
It won't be domestic.
Boom, boom. All right, now you see we are getting ready to land. Now, right before we land, there is going to be a small emergency. You see, the emergency exit will blow off. Don't worry. Remind yourselves to put your mask on first before you assist children. Except, and again, I'll just remind you that I'm just reading the script the captain provided me for that fucker in 13B. There is no mask around you. I've cut the wires, and you're about to take a flight down to the ground.
Scene.
I was led to understand that all of the golden lion tamarins in this enclosure spoke Portuguese.
Yes, that's right. Yes, all of them speak Portuguese.
Well, I'm just having trouble understanding the accent, I guess. I don't know what, I mean, I'm a Brazilian primatologist. I'm here to work with the golden lion tamarins and really having a hard time understanding them.
Oh yeah. They speak a very distinct dialect, in fact. You really have to start picking it up. You know, once you're around here for a couple of months, you really start to get, hey, Pontegesta, down it.
Oh, I don't know if I'm going to be able to master that. I mean, that was very, very unconventional Portuguese.
I know. It's just, so think of this zoo like an island. And you know how islands there can be language isolates. So the monkeys here speak a kind of pidgin between English and Portuguese and the pure rage of being locked in a cage. And together they kind of form their own little language. Que pasa? Que pasa dia? Que pasa dia cana?
Cut to the tamarins.
Que pasa dia? Que pasa dia?
Cut back to the zookeepers. They've written a little manifesto.
Oh, you want me to read it for you?
Yeah, please.
Okay. Oh, this is just, it's just vulgar. It mostly just says, we want to go home. And then it's 17 lines in graphic detail of specifically what they're going to do to your eye sockets. I could translate the rest, but again, there is some vulgar detail involving bananas and involving their own shit. And involving their tongues, and you know, I think you can get. I mean, they paint a very vivid and descriptive and beautiful picture, but one that maybe you don't want to really have in your head.
Cut to the tambourines writing the manifesto.
Pockets, die. Shit!
Yes.
15!
Yes. She said that.
Que pasa?
Yes.
Cut to a meeting with Eileen at the UN. So, I'm sorry, you mean to tell me that you want to move to Canada because you feel that it is a threat, the country you live in, because of animals that speak Portuguese?
Yes. I feel like my only recourse is to permanently settle in Canada and maybe start to communicate in a different language with animals.
Well, do you speak French? Specifically Quebecois French? Because all of our animals speak that.
I can learn.
Can you? You seem not to learn the Portuguese for those animals. What makes you say you will learn Quebecois French for our animals? How will they learn to trust you?
God, this has just been the story of my life. I've been going from zoo to zoo, nation to nation, country to country. I speak many languages, but when I get there, the animals always speak a slightly different dialect.
What did you expect?
Cut to the French orangutans. Je ne sais pas ça. Well. Je ne sais pas. Oh.
Comment allez-vous?
Oh.
Ça va bien!
Oui, bien!
Il est me comprendre!
Oh, et tout? Et tout de suite? Oh, je suis fatigué!
Non, c'est dommage.
Si. Look,
is it okay if I film this? You don't, just keep going.
Okay. Okay, so Sparky, beloved family pet, we pushed him away. But he went somewhere better than
Mom, what do you mean? Also, don't look directly at the camera. Can you look to the side? This is normal documentary filmmaking 101. So just...
But I'm looking at you, sweetheart.
No. Okay.
I'm not here. I'm a filmmaker, remember? Right, that's what you said I could try in college for at least 1 year. So just look away.
Look, he missed you so much. And he started to get aggressive with my scissors and my needlepoint.
What?
And it just came to a head. And
look at that.
I had to push. No, Turkey, no. Stop it. Stop it, put them away. Sparky. I know you miss Sarah, sweetheart. I know, and I'm not her, and I'll never be her, but please, for the love of God. Do you wanna have a FaceTime? Do you want to have a FaceTime with Sarah?
Hey, Sparky. Oh, you so sweet boy. Oh, my little bubble mumpkin.
Oh. Come back. You know, all of those FaceTime calls were me under duress. I was trying to tell you how I was being taken hostage, basically.
Every time we called, Sparky was totally fine. Honestly, he's like a Scotty Doodle, you know? He's so cute. How could that be possible? Also, can you pause for a second? I need a different angle. Do you mind, like, shifting closer to the window?
Is that okay? Mm. Is my good side?
Yeah. You don't have to look sad. This is a sweet documentary about our beloved pets. Now just explain where Sparky is.
Look, Sarah, after the third week in a row of waking up in the night with that fucking dog just standing over me and his breath just in my face.
Cut to that.
Oh god, Sparky, no. Oh my god. Oh, Jesus Christ, buddy, you are, it's gross. Okay, all right, come on. Do you want to FaceTime Sarah? Is that what it is? Okay.
Mom, it's like 5 a.m.
Hey, yep.
Sparky.
It sure is. Sparky just wanted to say hi.
Hey,
honey. Say hi, buddy.
My sweet Google bottoms.
Hey, I miss you. I wish I could live at college with you, even though it's illegal. Sparky,
you know I do too, but they say no doggies.
That was the last time Sparky was ever saw. We've been looking for him ever since.
That's right. And I'd do it again if I had the chance. That goddamn dog was ruining my life. Threatening me.
What do you mean you do it again? What did you do?
I told you, Sarah. Sparky went someplace better. We pushed him away and he went somewhere better. So much better than in my family.
Where is better? We don't know. Could it be a farm? Could it be the basement? Could it be...
My flowers are growing so well this year.
We'll find out next time on Serial.
The podcast awards for 2020 go to Valerie Garrison for her work on My Sparky, My Mother.
I'd like to thank everyone who helped me with this. First off, I want to credit my time at the Brooklyn Zoo. I went there one day and just met the zookeeper who convinced me that animals were a path to life, really. In fact, I brought her here with me today Zookeeper Eileen, maybe you could share, how did you learn to speak to animals that way?
Well, you know, I learned after many years of frustrating moves from zoo to zoo across the planet that there's only one real way to speak to animals, and that is through the language of food and the heart.
I'm sorry, this is the PA system calling. There is a fire in this theater of the awards ceremony. I'm advising everybody to go to the exit, except, and I'm sorry, I am reading this for the owner of the theater, that fucker in 7A, you broke my heart and you can die in a fire, you asshole.
And that's okay because it's just a domestic dispute.
You should be rolling me. You're a real life fantasy. You're a real life fantasy. But you're moving so carefully. Let's start living dangerously. Talk to me, baby. Improv bingo. If you got bingo, just put it in the chat and we'll follow up. If you didn't, don't worry. There are always more opportunities to see improv, have a lot of fun, and just enjoy life as it is, as it comes to you. If you want to watch more of Highwire Improv or pitch a show or sign up one of our classes, you can do that all at highwireimprov.com. There you'll find all different ways that you can bring more joy like tonight into your life. Until tomorrow or until the next time I see you, everybody have a good night.
Inclined to make me rise an hour early, just like daylight savings time. You and me, baby, ain't nothing but mammals, so let's do it like